Module 5, Exercise 3. In this exercise, we are going to calculate the mean NDVI per land cover class. We use the knowledge that we already have, so I'm going to load exercise 1 of Module 4, where we calculated the normalized difference vegetation index, and simply copy the code. Copy the code to the end of the classification script, so we also have NDVI calculated. Make sure that the variables have the same names. In our case, the name of the image is not image, but it's composite. Let's run it to see if it works. It's always good to, while you're coding, check if the code until a certain point works. Otherwise, it will be a bit hard to debug. So that worked. Now we can add the code for the calculation of the mean NDVI per land cover class. And first we need to create a stack with NDVI and the classified image. And therefore I create a new variable called stack. And we take the NDVI image and we add a band to that image with the classified layer. So stack has now two bands. Band 0 is NDVI and band 1 is classified. And now I can use that in a so-called grouped reducer. Create a new variable for the reducer, stats for statistics, and I use the stack, and then reduce region. Then in the dictionary, I define the reducer, and we define another dictionary for the group. So the group field key identifies which band has the classes, and that is band 1, our classified layer. Group name is a string for the output of the name of the classes. In our case, let's call it land cover class. It was to identify the group. Then we complete the dictionary of the reducer by identifying the geometry, which is the ULB polygon. And because this area is really huge, I'm going to use a coarse scale of 10 kilometer pixels on which this statistic will be calculated. You can play with the value, but if it's too much calculation, then you'll get probably errors. And finally, I want to print the statistics, and that will print the dictionary. Let's run and see. Our dictionary is ready, and let's see what it contains. And it has the land cover classes with the mean values, and we see that indeed the vegetation has the highest NDVI. And urban and bare are low, and water is negative. So for the assignment, you're going to repeat this for the MNWI and see if then the water class also there has the highest value. Good luck.